Okay, so this is the Snap and Sew here. It's battery powered, ATtiny 85. Has a speaker, an LED light detector, and a touch sensor. And we'll play a song and then it'll start flashing a heartbeat. And this is designed to be easy to assemble and test. And then once you've tested it, you can break it apart and sew it into a soft circuit. So first thing I'm going to show you is how we solder it together here. And the first thing is to make sure you've got all your parts here. So got conductive thread and needle, which we'll use later. Circuit boards, battery holder. At the program chip, we have a resistor, the LED switch. This is the light sensor. And here's our speaker. So we've got everything we need. Alright, so when I'm soldering, I usually like to work highest to lowest on the board. And I think in this case, we'll take the 8-pin microcontroller. Now, I usually paint a little dot up in the corner where it indicates pin number one, and then on your board you'll have a little notch to indicate where the top of the... Very critical, if you don't get this in right, it does not work. So that's in, so I'm going to flip it over. And with any component that has more than two leads, I like to solder in two to start with. So I'll solder in one corner and then the other corner. And then I'll flip it over and want to make sure it's seated flat to the board, and we want to check our orientation again, because after we solder more than two in, it's going to get real tough. So that's in there the correct way. So I'm going to go ahead and finish it. So I'm not going to make this a how to solder video. There's some others that have been done really well and show the close-up parts better than I can show you, but you can just see from my general technique, I'm holding the tip against the lead and waiting about 2 seconds. I'm using a SparkFun $10 soldering iron. I really like it. It works well, and I'm using lead-free solder, so you can see that it works well at the higher temperature. Okay, so the MCU is in place. Now this battery pad, you can add just a little blob of solder on here so it helps the battery make contact. And I'm going to hold it down. It takes it a little minute to soak up some heat. I'm going to feed it in there and then let it kind of wick out. And that'll just help make a good electrical contact with the battery when it goes in. The battery casing has a curved section on the opening that'll match the curved section on the board. And this will work with either through hole or surface mount varieties of this, but I like the through hole because it's a little better mechanically if these get dropped. And so that's going to fit on there like that, and then I'll flip it over. And let's prop it up just a little bit to help us here. Again, I'm going to solder those two in and then flip it over and check to make sure the standoffs are the correct height and we've got the battery opening on the right height. If not, you're not going to be able to slide your battery in there. So let's come in and finish these off. Okay. Battery, MCU, so let's start working up here. Let's put our speaker in next. This will come with a little bit of tape on it. And you can't just pull it out, but sometimes the plastic pops off, so you should just clip the leads. There's no polarity on this. This is a PS1240 speaker, and it's in a narrow package, which I like for soft circuits. So there's no polarity, so it goes in either way. And we'll flip it upside down and solder that place. And we'll nip these leads off. As you can see, this is going together very quickly. This is a ideal project for a beginner. Let's put in our, so next to the MCU, there's two sets of six pads. One of them is for the ISP programmer if you decide to reprogram your chip, and the other is for the speaker, or I'm sorry, the switch. Now this should not, I've made these pads a little bit smaller, so you should not be able to quite get these in the wrong way. Famous last words. Anyway, so you want them to go into the six holes that say SW, and it has the on indicator next to it, and that should sit right about the height of the MCU. So flip that over. And again, I'm just going to do those two leads, and then we'll double check and see if it's seated correctly. I'll take that. Okay, and that leaves us, let's do the LED and the resistor here. So this thing will be operating at 3 volts, so it technically doesn't need a resistor for the LED for current limiting, but it helps with battery life, and it also helps if you do hook it in to program it. The program will be providing 5 volts, and that could pop your LED if you didn't. So I'm using a 330 ohm resistor. It's just kind of my standard go-to resistor, feeding the leads through. And you can see in a lot of cases I've put silk screen on the back of these for when you're sewing them in, that you can see what you're doing, which leads positive and which leads negative. And we'll clip this down. So I'm just going to put in a standard little red 3mm LED. You can pick and choose your color. This will beat, has like a heartbeat, is why I kind of like that. So in the round circular silk screen for the LED, there's a positive mark next to the positive lead, and the long lead on an LED is positive. And if you have any doubts about that, you can grab your handy coin cell and verify that. So long lead goes in positive. And you can see it can hold a 5mm LED, or if you put the resistor on the back, you could get a 10mm LED in there too. So depending on what you want to do. Okay, and I've saved probably the trickiest item here for last. This is a light detecting transistor, a photo transistor. In the past, I've used a lot of, these are photoresistors or LDRs or cadmium sulfide cells, and they would go in right here, and that's what the silk screening is. These do have cadmium in them, so I can't ship them overseas, and the transistor circuit works much faster and is less expensive, so that's why I've gone to it. The silk screen hasn't quite caught up with that fact yet. So the emitter on this package, and you can look at the data sheet if you need help, is the long one, and I think of that normally as negative, and so that one's going to go to the lead farthest away from the board, and we're going to have to remember that too when we so I do have a plus marked on here, so we'll know which one to solder or sew into, but for now we just need to know that the long lead goes into the one farthest away from the hole. And I'll solder that out. Okay, time for a quick check. So on the touchpad, there's also pads for putting in a tactile button if you want. I usually don't do that. Kind of like just being able to touch it when it's flat, and that the resistance of your finger causes enough of a change that the microcontroller can detect it. So just want to double check and make sure I got all my solder on here. Switch it off position. We'll throw a battery in here. And power up. So I saw one flash, and if you trigger it, so it'll operate on a change of light or on a touch. You can turn it on and off, and then there's actually three songs in here and one without a song. So the way to change that is if you turn it off, you hold the button down and turn it back on. And then I saw two flashes there, so now it should be in silent mode, which I'm sure your parents might appreciate it. And now it just goes into the flashing heartbeat. And you can change the amount of time this goes. I think we got it set for about 60 seconds. Shuts down, saves the battery, checks the light levels. So that's the other thing, is if the light levels change, get it to do it here. I've got an awful lot of bright light on here. Let's see. Then it will come on. So it acts kind of like a night light. Okay, let's see. So it does remember. So every time you turn it on and off, it'll be whatever the last program setting was. And you saw the two flashes as the silent. And then we'll do it one more time. Three flashes. Get you twinkle twinkle little star, and then the LED will start blinking randomly. So that would be a good one if you had a yellow LED and wanted some stars to twinkle. And then the final one is happy birthday. And again, these are just programmed in with the Nokia RTTL tones. And so if you are a programmer, you can get in there and change these around to whatever you want. There's some cool ones, Star Wars and things like that. And it's flickering randomly again. So if you had like a candle, a yellow LED. Okay, hopefully I convinced you this is an easy and fun project. You can see my other instructables to see how to put this into a circuit, but the cool thing is we've already tested it out, so we know it's good to go. Thanks for watching.